I need to talk to someone about something that I saw, and I didn't imagine anything. In Northern California, I just drove back to Seattle.
Okay, could you give us a description of what you saw?
Well, it looked like a UFO, and I lost 2 hours of my time, and I don't know what happened. And when I came to, I was driving. My son's a policeman in the little town that I was living in, and I started to drive back to Seattle. And he says, "Mom, you must have had a stroke or something, you know." There's no way. I mean, I'm 61 years old, and I know what I saw. And it was like someone had, you know, like somebody had slipped something, you know, to me, and I'm just coming out of it. But I'm, you know, when I came to, I was driving on the road. But anyway, I've never heard of anything like this before, where it was a color other than silver. But this was a, a faded red, if there is such a thing.
Okay. Now, what roadway were you on?
I was up at Clear Lake, California.
Okay, and what time of the day was this?
Oh, it was 5 o'clock in the morning, right before 5 o'clock in the morning. And I remember there was no one home at the time. My son's an undercover policeman down to Lake County, and his fiance was working. She's a jailer for them. And they were working, and I started to drive back home to Seattle, and I left right before 5 o'clock in the morning. And I turned my lights on, back down the driveway, and their house was on the side of a hill overlooking Clear Lake. And when I backed out, I remember, you know, turned my lights on, and I started going down the road and got to there's a bend in the road, and then that's all I remember. Ahead of me on the right-hand side on the ground, it looked like, I would say, 2 to 3 blocks away, was this object, and it looked like about 3 or 4 little people coming out of it.
Okay.
But I can see exactly what it looked like, and there was little oval windows in it around where, you know, I don't know how to tell you. It's like, sort of like a balloon, except if you squash it and it kind of pooched out the side. It was not, oh gosh, I sound dumb. I know describing something like that. Well, it wasn't flat, but it was sort of, I don't know what to tell you it looked like, except it had oval windows around the middle seam. I mean, if it had a seam, you know, I didn't see a seam or anything. But it looked like little oval windows around the side that I saw. And it, you know, and I thought, maybe I dreamed it. But the first thing, and I don't remember anything from there until I woke up. Now, when I got to the dead end street where I was headed for, and the lake was down the hill from that, and I could go right or left. Well, I would have to go right to get out. It's about 50 or 60 miles out to the freeway, out to I-5. So I would have had to turn left to get out to that. But when I woke up, east. When I woke up, I was heading west, and I was on Soda Bay Road. And all at once, I saw this road, and I didn't know where I was at or what I was doing. You know, I mean, I knew what I was doing. I was driving my van. I have an 85 Dodge Caravan.
Yes.
And this road looked familiar to on the left-hand side. And so I turned, and I went up there because I was totally lost. I just knew nothing. I went up there, and I saw the house that I had just left, but I didn't know who lived there. All I could think of was, this looks familiar. I've seen that house. I've been in that house. But I didn't know who was in it or who lived in it. And so I had my bearings then, so I turned around and I went back toward the stop sign, you know, where I saw this object sitting. And then I turned left. I went back, headed back toward Lakeport because I knew I'd be all right if I got to Lakeport. I was still real fuzzy. And there was a marina down on the right-hand side, and I thought, well, if I could just stop and get a cup of coffee, maybe I could remember what happened. And I remember stopping, and there was people out there going fishing or going out to the boat, and I remember asking, which road do I take to get to Lakeport? I've been driving down there for years and years and years, and So this guy that was out there by his car said, just go back up the hill here and turn to the right. And that's, nothing was familiar to me until I got into Lakeport. And I saw this big grocery store where we, you know, when I was down there, I'd take my grandchildren and we'd go shopping. And it was Bruno's. And I got out of my car, and there was a phone booth out there. And on the front seat of my car, that was my son and his wife getting a divorce. But here's a name. It said, send me and the kids, and gave an address that I was not familiar with and a telephone number. So I didn't even remember my son. But all I had to make, you know, to recognize anything was that Cindy and the kids and the telephone number, but I didn't recognize the address. So I called that number, and when she answered, then I knew who she was. And I said, Cindy, I said, I've just woken up, and I've been driving, and I don't know where I've been for the last 2 hours, because it was right at 7 o'clock in the morning. And she says, well, did you spend the night at Howard's with my son? And I said, I don't know. So then, she started asking me more questions. She said, just stay there, and I'll be right there. So she came down there, but by that time I was fully awake, but I could not remember last. But at 4 o'clock in the morning, I got up, and I got ready to go, and I put my makeup on, you know, got everything out of the house and everything. So I was fully awake then. It was just that when I backed out of that car and started to drive. So then she made me follow her to her house, and try to get a hold of my son and so forth. So I said, no, I'm okay now. Everything started coming back. But when she was talking to me, when she got to the van, you know, to my Dodge Caravan, she started asking me questions. She said, well, did you spend the night at Howard's last night? I said, I don't know. And I said, what do you mean? Because I'd forgotten that they were even getting a divorce. I mean, that much had been blacked out, too. And she said, well, we've been separated for 8 months. And she says, he lives up on the hill, you know, and then everything started slowly coming back to me. And it was the weirdest thing I've ever in my life had happen. And I didn't have any bruises on me or anything that, you know, but when I this Saturday night, I left about 10 o'clock in the morning from Lakeport.
Yes.
And I spent the night in Eugene with some family there. And when I went to take a shower, I have a bruise spot between the ribs and my stomach. And it kind of looked like a needle, you know, a place where a needle had been stuck in and bruised me.
Can you still see that?
Oh, yeah.
Okay.
I'm at my daughter's house right now.
Has anybody photographed that?
No. My son didn't believe me. I mean, kind of, I'm 61 years old, almost 62 years old, and he just thought that I had a stroke, you know, and he's, years ago, I had an experience up there that I told him about then, and I said, I may never come back again if I have to drive at night, but anyway, this was night again, because the car lights on my car that I was, I just retired from Alaska Airlines, and when I would get off work, before I'd jump on the plane, go down, drive in the Oakland, rent a car, and then go over half of, you know, the real winding, steep road, but that was the easiest way for me to get into where he's living. And this one time, the car light started, right in the winding part of the road, the car light from the car just started flashing. And something just said, no. And I kept going in between the flashes. I took my foot off the brake and just kept going. And it did three times to me like that. And it scared me. And, I mean, I remembered everything. I mean, there was nothing, it wasn't anything like this. But this, I've lost 2 hours. It has worried the stuffing out of me. I don't know where I was or what I was doing. Just when I came to and I was driving and then got my bearings back, and it was weird. And I don't think my daughter believes that I'm calling from her house, but I don't think she believes me either, but.
Well, let's go back to when you first started. You got on the road and you were starting out and you spotted the object. Was that in an open field?
Yes, there was no house on the corner. It was not. I remember seeing an open field. It's funny, I never. It was. I think it was at the end of the street. Now, there's no house right on the corner to my knowledge. I don't know. Or maybe I turned the corner, but I don't remember turning the corner. All I remember was the road is not straight going up to my son's house or where he lives. Yet there was a bend in the road, and it looked like on my right down the road I could see. I can picture it, but it's hard for me to tell you, you know.
Yes.
But it wasn't anything that landed. It had already landed, whatever it was. It was already there.
Already on the ground.
It was already on the ground.
Okay.
And maybe I'm just thinking it was in the road because that is all I remembered, you know, that the road was down that way. But I swear, I don't know. I feel kind of foolish even telling anybody this much of it, but it just worried me because I don't know where my 2 hours were spent.
Okay. Any estimate of the size of the object?
Oh, golly. You know, it wasn't real huge. I would say it was not really high either. Let me think for a minute. I would think it would be no more than 10 to 12, maybe 12 feet high.
Okay.
And I would say that it was no more than, if you would measure from one side to the other, maybe no more than 15, because it was kind of, in the middle it was kind of flatter, you know, it was kind of 15 to 20.
Okay.
Maybe 15.
And that was close to the roadway?
Yes, it was.
Okay.
I don't have my phone back in the house, yes, I won't have, but I want to call my son and see if he'll go down and see if there was, you know, anything down there.
Uh-huh.
It just worries me. But it may not have been at the end of that road, I don't know. But where it was an open field, so to speak, where I saw it, it was in the corner of the road. But that was, I'm not going down there again at night. I mean, I'm not going to be driving at night, that is for sure. That does it. So.
Okay, now, are you living in Seattle now?
Yeah, I live out by the airport.
Oh, okay.
I just retired working for Alaska Airlines as a supervisor in reservations building. And I've been retired for about 3 months.
Okay.
But it didn't have that kind of effect on me, believe me.
Okay, we'd like to get back to you on this. And
I'm sure that was the craziest thing that ever in my life has happened to me. And I'm an alert person. I'm not some dingling, you know, that dreams up something like this.
Right.
And
it would be possible for somebody to photograph that spot in your body.
Sure, I don't. Yeah. It's been bruised since. That Saturday.
Okay. If at all possible, we'd like to have somebody get some shots of that if someone has a good camera.
Okay, you want me to find somebody to take a picture of it?
With someone in your family, if possible.
Well, see, I only have a daughter that lives here, and I don't even think she has a camera.
Oh, okay.
And both of my cameras are in Fairbanks, of Fairbanks, Alaska.
Oh, okay.
It's, that one spot is about a little bit bigger than my thumb, and then it has a tinier spot alongside of it.
Okay. All right, we'll see if we can't get somebody in there. We'll have them call you well ahead of time after Thursday.
Okay. I assume it'll still be there by that time, but it really, when I saw it Saturday night after I took a shower, it really looked like something had, you know, something had poked me there.
Okay. And if you... As you remember new things, it might be a good idea to write it down.
Okay.
So you don't forget.
I can just see it, yeah. I mean, I just don't... It was just a real puzzle to me. So...
We appreciate your calling and reporting that.
Okay. Is this a government office? I know they don't... Or not?
No, it's private.
Okay.
Private organization. It's the National Reporting Center.
Okay, because I didn't want to report to the government... offices, because they usually, you know, there's nothing to it, they
right.
say. But I know what I know.
Well, it sounds like you've had an experience that's been reported around the world for many years now.
Well, this was so weird because, I mean, I was fully awake, I was dressed, I had my makeup on and everything, and when I left that house, and I remember backing out, turning my lights on, backing out of the driveway, and starting out, and then I saw the next thing I knew is I saw this object, so I don't know if I actually went down and turned right to go out the highway like I intended to do. Oh, I just don't know. And I'm not one, you know, I'm just alert to everything. So it was weird to wake up and find myself driving.
Okay, maybe we can come up with some answers for you.
Oh, I hope so.
Thanks again.
It sure makes me wonder.
Okay.
Thanks.
Bye-bye. UFO Reporting Center?
See, are you the person I just talked to?
Yes, ma'am.
Oh, okay. I just remembered, as soon as I hung up the phone, I remembered something else.
Okay.
When I came to, my right arm was throbbing so bad, and there was nothing wrong with it before I got in the car.
Uh-huh.
But it's just like my arm had been pulled out of socket and twisted. And,
That would be up in the joint, you mean?
Yeah, right in the joint itself.
Okay.
And also the back of my neck, I had a dull throbbing. In fact, when I got back to my son's house, they called him on the radio, and he went to, you know, I stopped at his house, and on the way out, and he gave me a couple of Advil. I said, you know, I don't have a splitting headache or anything, but I've got this dull aching in the back of my neck. It wasn't in the bones or anything. It was just in the back of, you know, the back of the neck part. And so I thought maybe I better tell you about that. Because
okay.
I complained a lot about that. I couldn't raise my hand up above my head. You know, I started to, and I let out this yell, and I started to reach up to see if my hair, you know, fix my hair and so forth, see it. And when I did that, I let out this yell, and I just couldn't hardly do anything for, it lasted probably a day and a half or so. It didn't bother me too much last night.
Okay.
But you know, there was nothing wrong with it. That's what I couldn't figure out.
Okay. Now, did you give me the date of that incident?
It was Saturday.
Saturday.
I don't know what Saturday.
That'd be the 24th. Yeah.
Yeah, I guess it was. It was Saturday, and it was, I left the house about a quarter to five because I was up at four.
Okay.
And I left at a quarter of five, and when I went to that phone booth, it was right at 7 o'clock.
Okay.
So it was roughly 2 hours there when I can't remember anything.
Okay, we'll be getting back to you.
Okay, thanks a lot.
Thanks again.
Bye.